everyone. Good morning, everyone. I hope all is doing well. This Sunday's announcements include Bible study this Wednesday at 11 a.m. and also the same day at 6 p.m. There'll be prayer this Tuesday at 7 a.m. and also Friday at 7 a.m. There's a church check-in every Sunday at 6 p.m. And there will also be a COVID-19 vaccine information session Sunday, February 7th at 3 p.m. Thank you, and this concludes our announcements for today. This is Jalen Gayfield.
Please bow your heads. Dear God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for who you are and what you do. We invite your Holy Spirit into our worship today. Let us know that you are here. We want to feel your presence. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
I hear you.
Good morning. Let us affirm our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From this he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
We need you to fly. You got the control. Now we're
January at Jimmy John's. Use promo code.
We ain't get to finish it.
Good morning, everybody. It's giving time. All right. So there are various ways that we can give. Okay. So I'm just going to list them. So you are able to give or make a donation by simply doing it in person, by mail, by scheduled pickup, or through the app Givelify. Now I'm going to bless our offering. Okay. Lord, we thank you for the blessing. Lord, we thank you for blessing us to give back to you. Bless all that we receive in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning, my Murchison family. Good morning. Today's speaker is no stranger to us at Murchison. She is the one and only Michelle Eunice. Michelle is a leader in conversations about faith, race, and culture amongst Black millennials. Her budding podcast, Christ Over Culture, is a platform for millennials to have honest conversations about being a Christian in today's society. Michelle and her guests share personal testimonies and practical ways to keep the Word of God over the influence of culture in everyday life. Michelle is a 2013 graduate of Spelman College and a 2015 graduate of the University of Texas School of Public Health. Michelle enjoys reading, traveling, and Mediterranean food. And we are so excited to have our very own daughter of Murchison bring forth an inspirational message for all of us this morning. Amen.
Good morning, Murchison Church family. I hope y'all are doing well. If you can, just type in the chat, good morning. I want to see who's here. I want to thank the young adults for inviting me here. And that song, Thankful For It All, was just amazing. So, it literally just fills me with emotion because I really am thankful for it all. And I'm going to try not to cry this morning because we got a word, but I'm definitely going to let the Spirit move. I'm so happy to see you in the chat. Today's message is all about being an influencer. And that is what we're going to talk about today. So this may be a little bit of a different message. I'm going to put my own little flavor on it, but nevertheless, it's going to be a word from the Lord. And I just can't express how elated I am to be here. It's been 7 years since I've lived in Houston and come back to St. Louis. So it truly feels like a homecoming of sorts, and to be able to speak here with my church family is awesome. And through the years, I've gone through ups and downs, trials and tribulations, but I'm thankful for it all. So today's message is all about being an influencer, which I think is so timely for today's world. I'm gonna go ahead and open us up in prayer, and then we're gonna get started. So Lord, we just thank you for it all. We thank you for this day, God. We thank you for bringing us here. We thank you for the word that you're going to share today. Thank you for putting me in this position, God, to come back and be able to share some inspiration with my church family. Lord, I pray that you just have your way, Holy Spirit. Calm anything that has happened before, during, or after this service, and let this just be a moment where we are solely focused on you, God. Calm any fears, God. Move me out of the way and have your way in this place. Holy Spirit, we just thank you for this church family. We thank you for the youth and the young adults who have put together this amazing service. We thank you for their lives. We pray that this message is timely for them and that it will ripple for generations to come. We thank you for their parents. We thank you for the church family who has raised us. And we just give you all the glory and the honor and the praise for not just what you do, God, but ultimately for who you are. It's in Jesus' name I pray and give you the praise. Amen. So today's message is all about being an influencer. And if you have lived through 2020 and the beginning of 2021, you know that we live in a world that is filled with a lot of chaos and confusion. You know, I'm just going to cut to the chase. It is crazy out here. And oftentimes it can seem like there's a lot of evil in the world that may be overcoming the good. But I'm here to tell you today, I have stopped by, this is a news flash, to tell you that you are an influencer. You are connected and tied to the body of Christ through Murchison. You are tied to the body of Christ through your relationship with Jesus Christ. And therefore, you have the ability to overcome evil with good. And so today's scripture is Romans 12:21. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. And I believe that each and every one of us has the power, the will, and the capacity to do that through the power of the Holy Spirit, not on our own, not in our strength, not in our power, but by the Spirit of God. So while it seems like things can be really, really crazy, I just want to remind you that you have the power to set the atmosphere of the room. So when I think about influence and the definition of influence and who is an influencer and what is an influencer, of course, I have to go to Google and say, what is the definition of influence and influencer? The definition of influencer is the capacity to have an effect on the character development or behavior of someone or something. It's very simple. And being an influencer is something that I know my youth and my young adults have heard, and maybe even some of our church family members who are on social media, you know that it is a person or a thing that influences another. So when I think about influencers, and just recently in the news, I think about a Cicely Tyson, right? She influenced film and the pace of culture through TV and film. I think about Oprah Winfrey. I think about Larry King. These are people who influenced the media landscape in a way that if you were on their show, you made it. That held weight. That had influence. When I think about music, I think about Beyonce, Drake. I think about Marvin Sapp. I think about Anthony Brown and Group Therapy, right? Like, no matter what the genre is, they have influence. They can make you feel some type of way. They can motivate you. They can make you want to rise to a level of excellence. Same is true in sports. So we think about the Lakers and the Celtics who played last night. We think about the Bulls and the Warriors. They set the pace when it comes to titles and records and the NBA. They have influence. People want to be on their teams. People want to be like them. They have influence. And so no matter where you are, what your title is, what your age is, you have influence. And this message is just for just as much for our youth and young adults as it is for everyone within the church. So no matter if you're working, retired, no matter what it is, you have your own spheres of influence. There are people who look up to you. There are people who feel a certain way when they encounter you. And so I want you to hold that as value and as weight, that when you step into a room and when you step into a situation, you have influence. So we're going to talk about three spheres of influence today. And the first circle of influence that I want to share with you that each and every person has is the influence of your family. So 1 Corinthians 13:4-8 talks about love, right? So love is the core that holds the family together. Love is what Jesus Christ had for us, which is what made him go on the cross and die for us. So when we think about family, we can think about blood relatives. We can think about extended family. We can think about church family and overall the body of Christ. All of those different family relationships have a core of love. So 1 Corinthians 13:4-8 says, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no records of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith. It's always hopeful and endures through every circumstance. So you can show up in love everywhere you go. So you have the ability in your family, like I want you to think about your family relationships right now. Do you have a good relationship with your family? You can think about your immediate family, people who live within your household, extended family, church family. Do you have good relationships with those people? Are you exhibiting these characteristics of love? Now, we're not perfect and we never will be, but this is the mark, right? Like as Christians, as believers, our goal is to hit the mark and show love and display God's love and his word in our relationships, in our everyday lives. So as you think about your family relationships, are you being patient with your family members? I know I haven't always been. I will be the first one to admit this. And I know my mom is probably like, yes, Michelle gets short with me when I'm trying to do technology stuff. She's told me for the fifth time. You may be able to relate. But that's why God has given us his word as the mark, right? Like you think about your aim, the mark. So are you being loving? Are you being kind? And you have the power because if you're connected to God and the word, you know that not only do you know the word, but you have to take it a step further to then be influential when it comes to the word here in the earth. So the way that God shows up in our lives and in our families is through us. Like his Holy Spirit comes, his Holy Spirit dwells in us. And in order for us to be able to carry God's will out on earth, we have to display it. We can't just keep it bottled in and know 1 Corinthians 13:4-8, a scripture that we've heard all the time. We actually have to live it out and do it. So the first sphere and circle of influence you have is with your family, displaying love. So just one exercise this week or when you find yourself in your relationships, let's say you're in a heated argument or even if you're in a loving relationship, it's like, how can I continuously display love and be kind and be patient with people? How can I not keep records of wrongs? I think about our church family, right? Any group of people you put together, it won't be perfect, but there is undoubtedly a sense of love at Murchison. And so when I think about, you know, keeps no records of wrong, like, it's important for us to not keep records of wrong and to truly be the body of Christ and be displaying God's love for us in our church family. Like God loves us unconditionally. He's there for us. He shows up for us. He forgives us. And so I just encourage you to find ways that you can be more loving in your immediate family, in your extended family, as well as in your church family. And just cultivate that atmosphere of love. Even if you're not receiving it, you have the power and the influence to infuse love in that situation. So remember that whenever, no matter what situation or what circumstance or family relationship you find yourself in, you be the light and be the love in that situation. So the second circle of influence is actually work. Now this one can be really tricky. So some of us are working in person and we have to go and show up for work every day, especially our frontline workers. I think about teachers. I know we have educators here on the call. I know that we have medical workers here on the call. I know that we have a lot of folks who also work remotely. And it can be really challenging to be authentic and to show your full self at work and to really display God's love in a way that's not, I would say, overt. Like sometimes you can't always talk about or say Jesus or say God at work. Sometimes you can if you have those relationships with people, and I encourage you to find those people if you can. But even if you can't necessarily like say Jesus or God in your place of work, what you can do is have influence and display the fruit of the Spirit with anybody who you come in contact with. And that's where Galatians 5:22-23 comes in. And that's the scripture about the fruits of the Spirit. And it says, but the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against these things. So when your coworker is getting on your nerves, like think about the fruits of the spirit. And sometimes I even have to do this, and no matter where I am or where I've worked, I think about self-control, right? Sometimes we might get frustrated, or we may see injustices in the workplace. We may notice that, you know, it's difficult to think about race and race relations in our country and be able to really express that at work and be a Black person, a Black man, a Black woman, especially a young adult in your early career. You don't want to misstep or say the wrong thing that can, you know, just make you like get blackballed, or, you know, someone to look at you and try and put that as a mark against your career. But in any case, no matter what color or who you encounter, whether they are racist or not, or whether someone does you dirty or not at work, or if they find, like, if they have your back, you want to display the fruits of the spirit. You want to appreciate those people who are there to appreciate, and those people who aren't loving or kind, you want to show love towards them. You want to be joyful when they come into your presence. I think about how do people encounter you, and what do they feel when they're in your space? We talked about some of the celebrities and famous people earlier in this message. We think about Oprah. Like, when you think about Oprah, you might think of words like, she is inviting, she's welcoming, she's relatable. You and us, all of us, we have influence that when people at work come to us for whatever it is, we may not be waving the Jesus flag, but we can show them love. We can show them goodness. We can be faithful. We can have self-control. We can get our assignments done on time. We can show up for work, show up for meetings. We can speak up. These are ways that you can display that you are faithful in the works of the Lord. I think about the scripture where it talks about working unto the Lord, not unto man, and being confident in knowing that the work that you're doing will be recognized. Even if it's not recognized immediately or how you think it should be recognized, it will be, because we're working as unto the Lord. And when we do that, we want to exhibit excellence. And so think about your workplace, how people encounter you. You can set the tone and set the pace and set the atmosphere when people come into your space, and when they look at your work, and when they talk to you, just have a coffee, you have influence in that space. So when it comes to work, I would say make sure that you are showing up, and that when people call your name, even if they don't see Jesus, they know you. And as they get to know you, they'll be pointed back to Jesus. They'll want to know what's that sauce that's on you. And that comes from the fruit of the spirit in that relationship with God. So be an influencer in your workplace, no matter what level you are, and no matter what work you're doing, even if you're volunteering. A lot of our Murchison Church family volunteers at church or in the community. You are working as unto the Lord. So no matter what you're doing, show up, be faithful, continue to show love and joy. When people come off the streets, we are the first people that they see. They may not even know God, but they see us, and that's how God operates through us. So in your work, be influential and display the fruits of the Spirit. And our last sphere in this circle of influence is community. And so when I think about community, I really do think about Murchison as a pillar in the community. And I think about what makes up Murchison. And while the building is, like, we have so many memories in that building, a lot of us have gotten christened there, we've been raised there, we have our own community, we've been in so many different activities there. I think about what Murchison represents in the greater St. Louis community, in the country and the world. Murchison really sets the foundation for service, and that ties back to Jesus Christ. So because we are a Bible-believing, praying church, we model the characteristics and the behaviors of Jesus Christ, and that then spreads out to the community. And that's been something that's been consistent with Murchison over the years. I have no doubt that it will be. And I think about how that's been passed down generation to generation. Even for me, growing up in Murchison and then becoming a young adult, that foundation that was set at Murchison really equipped me to be that light in the community, even when I moved outside of St. Louis. So when we think about community, we think about Matthew 25:40, and that particular scripture says, then these righteous ones will reply, Lord, when did we ever see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink, or a stranger and show you hospitality, or naked and give you clothing? And the king will say, I tell you the truth, when you did it to the one of the least of these, my brothers and sisters, you were doing it to me. And so in this time, in this world, I just think about how it can seem like there's a lot of division in the community, whether it's politically, racially, etc. But I just want to encourage you to overcome evil with good, and you can do that in your community. When you're giving, whether it's donating to a charity, or if you see someone and they need, you know, a blanket or whatever the case may be, you know, in a safe environment, that is you showing the love of Christ. And one of the things that I have learned over the years is giving without expecting anything in return, and giving from your heart. I think about the scripture where they talk about being a cheerful giver, and I never really understood that until I understood the concept of giving without expectation of receiving. And when we give in our community and we take care of people, just the least of these, just because that is a servant's heart, the heart of Christ, which lives within the Murchison church family, which lives within us, then it enables us and empowers us to have a cheerful heart whenever we give. And so I just want to encourage you to be influential in your community. Join different community organizations, a board, give to a charity, whether it's, you know, once a year or quarterly or whatever you do, just continue to be that beacon of light in the community, because you never know whose life you're going to change. And us planting those seeds, it matters, it counts, because if everybody in the body of Christ is planting those seeds, imagine what that can do in a person's life who doesn't know Jesus Christ. Be influential in that way. We're not responsible for making that seed grow, but we can plant the seed through service and by caring for others in the least of these. And ultimately, no, you are caring for a daughter or son of Jesus Christ without return. So, and God will reward you. God will reward you. But when you give, and you give without that expectation of return, just because that's a servant's heart, God honors that and he sees that. So as we close today, I just want to remind you that you are an influencer. Hands down, no matter if you realize it or not, today's newsflash is you are an influencer. And as a Christian, as a believer in Jesus Christ, you have influence. I think about parents. I think about grandparents here on the call. I think about the youth and the young adults. Influence goes two ways. And just a note for my youth and young adults, a lot of us have grown up in Murchison. We have been a part of the church. We have family and friends that are a part of the church, and we've been influenced in a lot of ways being a part of Murchison in a lot of positive ways. And now I really feel like the tide is turning, where it is now our duty to be the influencer in the community. A lot of our generation isn't in church. And if they are in church, they are taking that information and putting it out into the world. And so as young adults, as youth, as parents, as grandparents, but specifically as youth and young adults, I want to let you know that this is your time to show up in your family, in your workplace, in your community as an influencer. And your parents will continue to have influence on you, but now you're in the role of making decisions. You get to decide what the atmosphere is in your family, in your relationships, in your marriages, in your workplace, within your team, when you move to management or whatever your career aspirations are, in your community. You can join the boards. And I think about even from a spiritual perspective and personally, when I started Christ Over Culture, which you see here and I have on my shirt, I started it in 2016. One of the really, the impetus of Christ Over Culture was me asking a question, what's influencing me? I really had to come to a point of, you know, understanding that I've lived in the world, I've gone to college, I've been raised by great parents, a great church family, came from a great community, but there are things that happened in my life where people doubted me. They thought I should do one career path or another. They thought I should be a certain place in my life at certain times. And I had to really get still and get in the Word of God and understand what I believed outside of my church family, outside of my family and my friends. Like, what does Michelle believe? And that's when my relationship with Jesus Christ really thrived, and it made a difference in my life. And that's something that's important, because in my personal life, that's what's going to keep you when the naysayers and the doubters say you shouldn't be at XYZ school, or you shouldn't be within this company or in this position, or say, how dare you think you have XYZ. Why? Because you're an influencer. That's why. Because you are a son or daughter of Jesus Christ. That's why. And he has equipped you for every good work. So when I think about Christ Over Culture, I literally had to drown out the world and the doubts of the world and really get into the Word of God and understand my relationship with Jesus Christ and say, my influence comes from the Word of God through that servant leadership, through that love, through that forgiveness, through excellence, through exhibiting the fruits of the Spirit, really understanding how people experience what they experience when they come into my space. When you step into my space, what do you feel? And that's where Christ Over Culture came from, and being able to share that experience with others. So don't let, you know, the noise and the ways of the world influence you. Influence the world. We need more believers who are not timid and who are not afraid to exhibit the fruits of the Spirit and to influence every place in their work. And that relationship with Jesus Christ, getting in the Word, is what's going to keep you, like I said, not only through the trials and the tribulations that happen a part of you, but it's going to keep you when your parent dies, which is something I just experienced. Like, you never know who God is unless you are in that Word and saying, you know what, the world might say I should be going crazy right now, I just don't know how to pick myself up, but Jesus Christ is close to people who mourn. He is there for you. And when you know that, you can speak with confidence. And you may be sad, you know, grief will come, but you know what, I know that my parent is in a better place, I know what they taught me, I know what influence they had on me. And now I can share that hope and that love and that influence with others. So that concludes my message for the day. Be an influencer. Don't let anybody talk you out of it, no matter how young you are, no matter how old you are. Grandparents, parents, you're influencing your kids, youth and young adults. It's now your time to pick that mantle up and influence others. You have your grandparents' prayers, but now it's time for you to learn how to pray. It's time for you to get in your Word and set the atmosphere and set the temperature in the places in your family, in your work, and in your community. So I love you guys. Thank you for allowing me to share a little bit of my story today to encourage you. And know that whether you like it or not, you have influence. And as long as you're connected to Jesus Christ, you can show who he is in every place you're in and be an influencer in that space, on social media, in your workplace, at home, etc. So love you guys, and I'll hand it over to continue the rest of the service.